Hey friends, did you know that Azure Event Hubs ingest more than 2 trillion messages per day? And as a distributed streaming platform, Event Hubs enables you to stream your data from any source, storing and processing millions of events per second. Shubha is here to show us how Event Hubs now works for Apache Kafka today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman, and it's another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Shubha Vijayasarathy, and we're talking about Event Hubs and Apache Kafka, two of my favorite things in big data.
Yes.
And you've brought me some cool demos as well.
Yes, I'll try.
Yeah, so what's going on with Event Hubs as it relates to Apache Kafka?
Event Hubs, as we know, is a distributed streaming platform, and Apache Kafka is also a distributed streaming platform. And we've tried our best as Event Hubs team to try to bring these two big data streaming platforms together, and that's what we'll see and how it is.
Cool. So you're going to make it so they can work together?
Yes. So if we start over, like if you see, what we see with big organizations is they have a lot of data points that they want to try and analyze so that they can improve, they can work on that, have better return of investment. So in any enterprise lifetime, you would be building data pipeline. And if you see how a typical data pipeline looks, it's like you have producers or the data points you're interested in. You start collecting, staging, and then ingressing, processing, modeling, and viewing. That's the whole typical data pipeline. And where Event Hubs or Kafka come in is as the front door for any streaming platform where you're ingesting before you store, you model, you process. So it's like a buffer, in a temporal buffer for your producers and consumers. So you can process them and ingest and process them to model and serve.
I see. So my producers can be anything. It could be IoT devices. It could be video or
clickstream
data.
Applications, clickstream, web apps, sensor data.
Okay. And you said it's like a buffer because some days you might have millions of requests a second and some days you might not. So it's coming and going.
I call it a buffer because your producers might produce at a different velocity and volume, where consumers can consume at a different velocity and volume. So you want a temporal something in between for your smart endpoints, so the pipeline just stays, so you don't have to, your producers need not be bothered about when the producers are ready.
And there's a whole ecosystem of ingestion systems
right here.
And you're unifying those.
Yes, exactly. You're just bringing that one big fat pipe so that your producers and consumers can have a straightened pipeline.
And do you find a lot of people out there that have streaming data, they might be using Kafka, and they don't know if they can bring it to Azure?
Yes, if you see, if you see the conceptual architecture of Event Hubs, you have Event Hubs or Kafka topic, very similar. And the way Event Hubs or Kafka has data is they have partitions in their in their architecture where the data gets distributed. So you have a bunch of event producers and a bunch of event receivers who are interested in this data, and the data gets distributed within Event Hubs or Kafka topics in a uniform pattern. So what happens with this, you're having a huge downstream parallelism where you're concurrently, you're letting your receivers concurrently read from all these partitions.
Right.
It's like it's called a partition consumer model, not like the typical competing consumer model that you would see in an enterprise.
Okay, and it's not necessarily pub-sub either.
You can make it as a pub-sub because you have events or messages coming in, getting distributed, and a couple of event receivers are interested in only a couple of things. So the thing is, it's a buffer, so it's not a push model, it's a pull model where you can do a lot on your receiving end. What this gives you is a scale. If you have 4 receivers today and I want to add 6 receivers, it just scales.
Awesome. And that's the great thing about Azure in general,
yes,
is it just scales.
And if you see, this is how the Kafka is. That's where many users come and say, like, you know, oh, now I have Kafka, I have Event Hubs, both streaming platform. Which one should I choose? Is it Event Hubs or Kafka? Because there are a lot of advantages with Kafka. Kafka is open source. Apache Kafka is open source. It's a software. It's downloaded. And Event Hubs is on cloud. It's a cloud offering. It's a PaaS offering. Mm-hmm. So the couple of pain points when we talk about Event Hubs or Apache Kafka is, which one do I choose? And many customers are already on Apache Kafka. It has an on-premise story.
Yeah.
And Event Hubs is only for cloud. So that's where we thought, you know, we bring in this and say, it's not or, it's and.
Absolutely.
So that's what our integration story is, where we are trying to say, we natively were built with HTTPS and AMQP, but now we understand Kafka protocol as well.
Interesting. So this reminds me of the time that I had the folks from the Cosmos DB side, and they said Cosmos is amazing, and it has all these features that you don't see anywhere else, but it's not something that's open source, and it doesn't have a protocol people understand. So they put Mongo in front of it, and now everyone wins.
That's right.
So the same thing is happening here. You're bringing Kafka to Event Hubs so that they work together, and that people who have existing producers can just get involved.
Yes. So the biggest advantage here is you're not changing any of your clients. You're not changing your code, your producers, or your applications, your tools, your frameworks. Kafka offers framework like Connect, which is trying to stream using Kafka with your source and destinations, your data sources and data destinations, which could be like your file streams, your databases, your JDBC SAP. All these will just work with Event Hubs.
So are you saying that I could take an existing app that I had written using Kafka libraries?
Yes.
Doesn't even know Azure exists thing.
Yes, it need not know anything about Event Hubs.
Okay, do you have a demo?
I do have. So what I have here is a sample Kafka producer. As you can see, there is no hint of Event Hubs anywhere. It's all using Kafka API. And I have a sample consumer as well. It's a simple Java program. Now, all I need to do on my producer and consumer is add a Bootstrap server entry, which is a Event Hubs namespace. How do you create Event Hubs namespace is you can go to the portal. I have one already created for you. This is testing for demo is my namespace. It's a Event Hubs namespace. You can just do create and create and click on Event Hubs. And the Event Hub comes in, and then you can start creating a namespace with it. It's just click, 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 and you
do I have to tell the namespace I want to use Kafka, or I get that
every namespace is Kafka enabled?
That's
so you don't have to explicitly say that it's Kafka.
That's nice.
So I already have a namespace created.
Okay.
I'll reuse that.
And I noticed in your connection string, they're using 9093. 9093 and 9092, those are standard ports. So really, your app looks like, your connection string looks like Kafka because it is Kafka.
Yeah, Kafka, most applications also use 9092. 9092 is a unsecured port. 9093 is a secured port. Event Hubs requires TLS handshake, and 9093 makes a lot of sense with that. So
nice. Okay.
I already have a testing for demo namespace, a sample namespace.
Okay.
What I need from is this connection strings.
Okay.
This gives me the endpoint that I can that is needed to talk to Event Hubs.
All right.
So this is where I can get my connection string.
All right.
I already have the connection string pasted. This is where you need to put your connection string. Just copy and paste. And this is the namespace. What Event Hubs namespace gives you is a unique FQDN, a fully qualified domain name. And that's what you need to append as well along with the namespace name. And that's where your Bootstrap server or your host server name would be. So that done, the same thing I would do for my consumer config as well. I'm just adding my Bootstrap server name and my connection string as my endpoint. And you're all ready to go, that's it.
Yeah, let's do it.
So I have the Kafka producer.
Okay.
Okay, I'll start. This is just sending some, say, 1,000 messages probably to my
So you're doing
space.
A Maven exec, and you're running that over in the producer side?
Yes. It's a simple Java app that I'm running.
Okay.
So it started.
There comes some data.
Now, as I'm running that.
And neither the producer nor the consumer know it's Event Hubs because they're talking the Kafka protocol on
yes,
the
Yes, absolutely.
That board. Okay.
So now I started my consumer app as well, which is it will start receiving the events that the producer sent.
Okay. Look at that.
Yep. And if you see, you can start seeing the data here.
And that's so nice. You get and you see the data in the portal in a comfortable place, as you already know and you already understand. And I can see that you've got filtering and metrics that you can go and dig into.
Yeah, all the metrics can, Azure Event Hubs has metrics using Azure Monitoring, with which you can build beautiful dashboards. Mm-hmm. You can use that. Kafka API also gives metrics, emits metrics that also can be used in lieu with Event Hubs. So mix and match works.
Really, so the administrative tools are consumers as well, and they can go and view that. Mm-hmm. So if you've already built a Kafka dashboard, you can point that at Event Hubs as well.
Yes, it should be, because if it's talking to Kafka API, you can talk to this as well.
That's so cool.
It's as simple as that. So we see that happening. While this is happening, I also want to show another interesting thing. Mm-hmm. We said, Event Hubs natively supports AMQP, mm-hmm. and now we opened up for Kafka, and many customers are wondering, okay, that means if I can send with AMQP and receive with Kafka, or send with Kafka and receive with AMQP?
That's clever.
I say yes. So I have a sample sender here.
Ooh, C#, okay.
C#, I know.
That's great, that's my language.
I know, so this, I know, this is all our language.
I know, that's cool though.
Yeah, so here I don't have any Kafka.
Okay.
I only have Event Hubs. This is the native Event Hubs mm-hmm. API. And I have, and as you can see.
So it says testing for demo. Is that the same?
Same namespace I'm using for the simplicity's sake.
Okay, but there's nothing that says Kafka here, so C# is thinking Event Hubs.
Correct.
Java thinking Kafka.
Correct. Although I have created another topic so that I can show the demo distinctively. Mm-hmm. The previous one used a topic called test, and this one is using a topic called test EH.
Oh, okay.
And if you see our consumer app.
Okay.
Now this is talking to this will be consuming from test EH. The previous consumer was consuming from the test topic. This will be using the test EH. So let's just run. The same thing goes. Our Event Hub client also requires an endpoint. It's connection string. It's the same thing. So let me run this. I'll still run it in the debug mode.
Okay.
And this should start.
So this is a
sender. Sending the messages, yes. Uh-huh. This is a AMQP send.
Okay.
Let the messages start, and I'll start. Okay, it's sending.
There we go.
Now I will start the.
So .NET back here and Java.
Java,
in front.
Yes.
And they're taught to two different universes, two different libraries, all brought together by Event Hubs using Kafka.
Correct.
That's so cool. So there's so many people out there who are probably watching this and thinking, oh, I already have something that I could use with this right away. And no code changes.
No code changes, just the config change. Instead of putting your Bootstrap servers, you'd be using the namespace or the FKDN for Event Hubs and connection string, which is an endpoint that you need to talk to Kafka. Furthermore, things like, there are tools like Mirror Maker, which mirror your Kafka clusters, be it on-prem or on cloud, to other Kafka clusters. So with this protocol, you can use tools like Mirror Maker to mirror your on-prem Kafka clusters onto Event Hubs, which is on cloud. That's like two line and configuration change, and you're migrating data from on-prem to cloud.
Wow. So is this available now? Can people start using this?
Yes, it's available. It's GA'd now. It's available in all Azure regions.
Okay.
And yeah, you can start using it. Let's stop this.
All right.
So this is the last of the slide that I have. Mm-hmm. So when people say, we said, okay, we integrated Event Hubs with Kafka. It's now like, you know, why would I need that? And this slide here, tries to explain everything, how you get a PaaS experience. Mm-hmm. You're not running your Zookeeper, mm-hmm. which is an orchestrator to run or to manage your Kafka clusters. There is no flavor of Zookeeper. Mm-hmm. You are not running any clusters. You're not running anything. You're just streaming the data, thinking of scaling, and using your current applications.
Fantastic. All these things you don't have to think about. You get to go and have that great Kafka ecosystem.
Correct.
As a service.
Exactly.
Using Event Hubs.
Yes.
That's fantastic.
The other thing is, like, you get not only the wider Kafka ecosystem with Event Hubs, mm-hmm. you get the wide Azure Event Hubs ecosystem with Kafka. So the mix and match works.
Fantastic.
So it can just work with stream analytics, with Azure functions, mm-hmm. and you can use the storage, the blobs, and Cosmos DB, and everything that Azure offers as well.
Well, thank you so much for sharing that with us.
Yeah, thank you, Scott.
All right, I am learning all about Azure Event Hubs and Apache Kafka today on Azure Friday.